My name is Stacy Adams, and I coordinate the Medical Laboratory Technology Program, and I also teach the courses within the program. I've been working as a medical technologist for 20 years now, about 10 years after I graduated college to get my master's in education, and taught in the elementary level for a little bit, worked with students when I worked at the hospital doing their clinical rotations, and then I knew this was something that I wanted to do. I wanted to move on from just the clinical piece to the whole education piece. As an MLT, you work in the clinical setting. You get bloods, body fluids. Sometimes people have a little more involved case where they have antibodies and we have to make sure that the blood is completely compatible. We also deal with traumas that come in through the ED for blood bank, and that's the transfusion medicine, as well as hematology, where we get to look at blood counts, and we're sometimes the first people to see if someone has a leukemia or if their treatment is working. We help healthcare providers with diagnoses of a lot of issues, and that honestly, that's just skimming the top. We do have a lot of analyzers. It's technology because we have a lot of instruments that we use. However, it's more than just having a patient sample, putting it on the analyzer. We do quality control, preventive maintenance to make sure that analyzer is working. You have to like science, and you have to be conscientious. You have to be able to organize time management, but it's that science piece. Because I can run a lab sample and I can relate it back to the patient. There's less patient contact. I think that we do have a big role in healthcare, but it's more behind the scenes. The program, it's a two-year associate degree. It is hybrid. There is going to be a great opportunity for jobs. A lot of people are retiring or going down to on-call or part-time because they're getting older. And there's flexibility as far as the hours, especially in a hospital, because hospital labs are open 7 days a week, 24 hours a day to take care of urgent care, emergency, and the in-house patients. You see a lot of normal stuff, and it's unfortunate for the patient, but it's the abnormal stuff that's just, it's amazing, because at that point, then we can say, this is what we have, and then the doctors can go forward and treat.